Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mike Lake, and I'm the editor-in-chief of the Geek Infusion. We're back with another Geek Infusion Plays video featuring Life is Strange. This is the third video, I believe, in the series, so let's just jump in here. We left you on a cliffhanger with some sort of dialogue choice. I'm talking to this kid here. He tried to hug me earlier, and I didn't, and that was a little awkward, but apparently I couldn't rewind, so oops. But yes, let's talk.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right?
Uh-oh.
You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal. Now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here. But don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
You know, when you can rewind time.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Back. Oops,
oh, man. You're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Oh, not cool. I knew that was gonna happen.
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
Wait,
in the bathroom!
No. Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren.
Oh, God,
oh Warren. Nice.
Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Security guard. Good timing for once.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that guy was about to try and kill me.
Thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
He got
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. It feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Nah, I'm not big on Jefferson.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson. Anyway.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Awkward. Just apologize. Always the best policy.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Sorry.
Are you about to fall asleep? Betcha she is.
Broken. Man, are you serial?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually needs a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
I'm just, like, suspicious of everything. Like, before there, I literally thought she was going to fall asleep and I was going to have to rewind time to stop us from dying. But I'm sure there'll be time for that. Well, I've already stopped her from getting killed, so that was something. But I didn't know that I knew her. That's interesting.
Come on in. Don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Oh, shit, home.
Ooh, a build. Ooh, boobs.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Music, you say? Can do.
It won't play without any power.
Where's the power, you mo of the foe? Shazam.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
There is the music. Box of pictures. Postcard. Drawer, perhaps.
Man, I remember this furniture. We had such a blast drawing these together.
Aww. This game is hitting weird nostalgia buttons. Except it's like nostalgia for an existence I didn't have.
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair.
Okay, seriously, can you just like tell me where the hell your music is?
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Party all night.
Not Little Miss Wallflower. I bet you've never even been to a party.
Oh, right. I went to your birthday blowout.
Max, you were 12 years old. That's sad. You should stick to taking photos.
Okay, seriously, where is the music? Oh, is this... No, it seems like... Desk. Search.
I think this junk swallowed her discs. Too bad I can't stream any music from Chloe's laptop, but I love how funky and outdated it is. She even covered it in punk stickers because Chloe doesn't give a shit.
I can relate.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into
okay,
these days.
Okay, but seriously, how the hell, where the hell is... Maybe it's in here.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Were. Stepdad she hates. Dad she liked. This is a tragic origin story. Okay. If I have a complaint about this game so far, it's that, like, you know, obviously I would just say, like, hey, where are your CDs so I can put them on? But instead it's like, let me just awkwardly look through all your things for 20 minutes while you sit there.
Nothing but junk in this suitcase.
But it's still interesting. It's just kind of like silly in a way, you know? What's this box?
Old cardboard boxes.
Let's let it fall on me.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dome.
Oh, no, thanks. I didn't. You saw nothing. Did I already look in here? Yeah, I did.
We had such a blast drawing these together.
Seriously, maybe there was something on the laptop.
She looks super happy.
Trash can?
Chloe's trash overflowed.
Let me look at this poster for the 17th time.
So it was Chloe who printed all those flyers.
Interesting. Chloe printed the flyers. Okay, this is weird. Like, ooh, let's search under the bed. Oh, they spotted me. Missing girl. Sorry.
Hey, give me that.
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up.
Dad
she was
died.
My angel.
Ah.
After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out.
Yeah, I already apologized.
I was 14.
Jeez.
We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks... your mom tried to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know?
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay?
God.
Something happened to her.
Let it go, lady.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Her disappearance is connected to those... that weird... club thing, isn't it? Somehow they're like some cult. Alright, anyway, yes, musique, c'est le temps pour jouer la musique. That was probably really horrible French, by the way, but you know, such as life.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
I'm gonna have to deal with her stepdad, aren't I? Garage. Downstairs, one would logically assume.
Goodbye, my Santa Monica dream.
Yeah, it must be. 15 kids in the backyard drinking wine. You tell me stories. Wait, is her dad the security guard? Oh man, he is a dick.
Nope, someone locked it from the other side. Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days.
Locked from the other side. Thanks again, Max, for helping me. No problem, that guy's an asshole.
Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
Man, I love the art style in this game. I gotta say, that's one of my favorite things about it. It's well written, too, and I'm enjoying all the voice acting and everything, but just, like, really my only thing that I don't like so far is when, like I was saying before, they just ask you to find something, and it's like, you know, why do I have to go through all your stuff?
I haven't seen this place in 5 years.
Why can't you
years?
Just tell me where it is?
Seems like
that
forever.
Would be a lot easier. I think I have to go.
Brr. I can feel autumn pushing out the summer.
Whoops. Garage? No. I don't think there's really anything out here. I mean, there's stuff to look at, but grave. Bongo.
We made this grave for Chloe's kitty. Poor Bongo.
No.
He never saw that car coming. That took Chloe and me the whole day to draw. It's almost invisible now.
It's just been sitting here for years? What is going on? Hey, basketball. Alright, well, I'm pretty sure that I can't get to the garage from out here. So, back in I go.
I should be able to find the tools I need here.
Disco.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell.
Already kind of.
He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get?
He's definitely a dick. Gun rack. Oh, yeah, son.
Chloe's stepdad is a veteran and a security guard? He must really hate her.
He is gonna be pissed when he finds me in here.
These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera.
Oh, what's this?
Wowzer, a map of Blackwell Academy.
Placement of cameras. Okay, let me close that. I saw nothing. Alright, I already looked through those files. Maybe they're out here. Okay, he has a big deer head on his wall. Get over here? No. Well, I could have maybe. No. Okay. Again, you would just say, hey, can you tell me where these tools are that I need to use to, like, that other girl? But instead, it's just like, I'll just search through your entire existence. Right, I already did this.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell.
And I did this one, too,
right?
He wants
to put surveillance.
This is the one with his ID. Yeah, okay.
Chloe's stepdad
Fantastic.
Is a veteran and a security guard? He must really hate her.
Uh, Let me look at it.
This must belong to Chloe's stepdad.
Food. What does that say? Corned beef?
I wonder what's in those files up there.
I feel like... Oh.
Nothing. This is so lame.
Blue plank? I feel like what I have to do is search those files, and then he's going to bust in and be like, what are you doing? And I'm going to rewind time. That's going to be my prediction of how this is going to go. Alright. Let's search through these. Oh.
Shit! Butterfingers!
Well, in for penny, in for pound.
Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her? Okay, this is getting totally weird.
Conspiracy. I'm glad I helped her. But yeah, I think we need to do. Oh wait, I didn't quite go back far enough, did I? Okay, so... is everything unspilled over there? Files are in place. Good. Okay, fantastic. Well, that being the case, let's look at his laptop.
No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
I'm in that mode of we have to look at every damn thing. Oh, man. Well, let's look at the gun rack. Switch on? Sure. Look.
One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Yes! Score!
Guns save lives. Guns stop crime. I'm not sure if that's how that...
Boom. Precision screwdrivers. Except, I can't reach them.
But if I turn on the washing machine, perhaps... that will... yeah. Of course.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
What, I can't just reach under the thing and...
yes, here's some ancient cardboard.
Okay. We got this.
Man, I should have done that before
the... oh, yes. I'm picking up what you're putting down. Okay, so... are they still under there? Yeah. Oh, damn.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Okay, so... push. Yeah, skip. Yeah, turn on. Bam. Turn off. And now pick these up and get caught by stepdad and...
yes, you have mad skills, Max.
Yeah, pretty much the man. Woman. Girl.
I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
Let's go. Whoops. Let's go, I say. There's some weird conspiracy business going on here. What did that say? Stuff? Really? That's some good flavor text right there. Stuff. Sup.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
I believe I shall. Bum, 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 bum. apparently I'm not so good with the fixing. I bet you she'll know how to do it.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see.
Wait, I've seen this before.
No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat?
In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
Now tell me the truth, Max.
Yep.
I was there, hiding in the corner. Damn, you're a ninja. A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize
me? Oh, what do I say, though? Because, I mean, clearly I didn't, but... I'll say I wasn't sure.
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared, too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Yep.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
I mean, I told... Yeah, I'm just gonna...
Absolutely. Nathan Prescott had a fucking gun on you.
Gutless prick. That was scary. Who did you tell?
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday.
Yeah.
And I seriously
owe
you, Max.
You kind of do.
I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
Sweet.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance. Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. Song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe,
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm not a kid anymore. I can't hide under the bed. Where else?
Just let me in now. Please.
1 second. My claw is stuck.
Fudge.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door. I'm giving you exactly 3 seconds to open the door.
There's nowhere to hide in here, for Pete's sake.
Three.
Shit.
What's going on in here? Why is she here?
None of your business.
I don't like strangers here.
Stop freaking. She's not a stranger. This is my friend.
Great. Another one of your friends. One of my guns is missing.
Yeah.
Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control.
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed.
Toking.
You're tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
It's not my pot.
Ew.
It's from Max.
Dude, not cool,
is this
man.
True?
Not cool. Man, that was dirty. I wonder if there really was a place to hide. It didn't seem like it, and it didn't let me rewind, so I'm assuming... You know what? Yes, it's mine. You're already gonna hate me anyway, so you might as well hate me a little more.
Yeah. My pot.
So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do
you? Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win.
But
anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can
hang. You're really not going to acknowledge the fact that you just completely threw me under the bus?
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
That's a little annoying. Like, you should be way more grateful and apologetic. Well, in any event, that's going to bring us to the end of this video. As usual, you can go to yourgeekinfusion.wordpress.com to find all the Geek Infusion content, as well as check the links in the description. If you enjoyed watching this, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And again, my name is Mike Lake. I'm the editor-in-chief of the Geek Infusion. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time.